In exaltation, we reach the eternal Jerusalem. We make our prayers through Christ.
Amen.
Bethphage and Bethany at the mount that is called Olivet. He sent two of his disciples, saying, "Go into the village opposite, where on entering you will find a colt tied, on which no one has ever yet sat. Untie it and bring it here. If anyone asks you, 'Where are you untying it? Why are you untying it?' you shall say this: 'The Lord has need of it.'" So those who were sent went away and found it as he had told them. And as they were untying the colt, its owner said to them, "Why are you untying the colt?" And they said, "The Lord has need of it." And they brought it to Jesus, and throwing their garments on the colt, they set Jesus upon it. And as he rode along, they spread their garments on the road. As he was now drawing near at the descent of the Mount of Olives, the whole multitude of the disciples began to rejoice and praise God with a loud voice for all the mighty works that they had seen, saying, "Blessed is the King who comes in the name of the Lord. Peace in heaven and glory in the highest." And some of the Pharisees in the multitude said to him, "Teacher, rebuke your disciples." He answered, "I tell you, with these we are silent, even the very stones will cry out."
Bless you, Lord Jesus Christ.
A brief exhortation. We have just heard from the Gospel of Luke, chapter 19, from verse 28. It is a traditional reading of a day like this. The church celebrates two key moments today. The first is the triumphal entry into Jerusalem, and the second part is passion in Jerusalem. Now, this entry into Jerusalem is very significant because, according to Luke, the whole of the event of Jesus was a movement to Jerusalem. In fact, according to Luke, from what Luke painted of his gospel, Jesus was moving to Jerusalem to bring to finality his work. And if you remember what happened in the Transfiguration at the mountain, we are told that the apostles woke up from their slumber to understand that Jesus and Moses and Elijah, they were actually discussing about this mission to Jerusalem. The mission to Jerusalem is actually the summary, the climax of the mission of Jesus. And so when he was planning this, the disciples understood that. and they had to use the opportunity to lead him in a way that really can pass the message to them and to people. And we see two things. The first is that Jesus asked them to go and get this donkey. And he called them, go to such and such place. Enter. You find the donkey, the colt. Untie it. Bring it. If anyone asks you, tell them that the Lord has need of it. What translation says that the master wants it. That's very interesting. And they went, they found it exactly as just as they were. As they were tying the donkey, the owners asked him, what is happening? What is it? And they told him, the master wants it. Now this phrase is important for us today as we show our faith, express to Christ our faith in Him who is our King. That the Lord wants it. That is all that is needed for us to let go whatever we have for the Lord. That the Lord wants it. As long as it is for the Lord, it's enough to let Him have it. As long as it is for the Lord, let it be. As long as it is for the Lord, I will say it. As long as it is for the Lord, I will do it. As long as it is for the Lord, I will go. As long as it is for the Lord, I will not go. As long as it is for the Lord, I will not say it. As long as it is, whatever it is, to do or not do, as long as it is for the Lord, we are going. As the apostles showed us, we are going to have this great ceremony of glorious songs and dancing, express to ourselves and to the world, Hosanna to our King. I'm going to be very brief, but in this briefness, let us in joy and in faith express our Hosanna to Christ our King. Dear brothers and sisters, like the crowds who have claimed Jesus in Jerusalem, let us go forth. They will expect to be a little orderly. Children will take the lead. Then young will follow. And then the elderly come behind. We also expect us to all be organized, take it slowly and put the music and sing together. And then enter into the church. Okay. Yeah. Ooh.